Hello viewers, welcome back to Vidyasagar Classes YouTube channel. So today's video is about OABS interview. Most of our viewers are asking me to prepare fresh videos on OABS interview. So now, as the OABS interview might be rescheduled, might be conducted in August. So for our viewers, from today onwards, we will prepare some videos regarding OABS interview. So please watch this video till the end, and I hope this video will give you some ideas and make you prepare for your OABS interview. So the most important question in the beginning, as an icebreaker, the interviewers often ask, tell me something about yourself. And most of you say, this is, my name is, I am, etc., XYZ. But the most important thing about yourself is that you have to tell your name, educational qualification. And if they ask about your family background, then tell otherwise not. And when you are telling something, be specific about your educational qualification, which is suited to be a teacher. To be a teacher, you need to do B.Ed, and if you have done M.Ed, so be it. So when they ask you, tell me something about yourself, you said, very simply you said, my name is Pradeep Kumar Mahapatra. I have done my B.Ed entrance in the year. Apart from, I have done my graduation from BJB College, Bhubaneswar, or whichever college you have done. And I am a young man with honesty and looking forward to be a teacher. So, this much, be brief. So, indirectly, you just tell them to ask some questions why you want to become a teacher. Because, as you said, and you must be previously prepared from the cross question, why you want to become a teacher. So, this answer must be simple, brief and specific. So, first thing you say, that teaching is one of the noblest professions, and these days, being a government teacher, particularly in teaching profession in OABS, KBS, the salary is also lucrative. So, teaching profession not only gives me job satisfaction, but also helps me to build our nation, because today's students or kids are tomorrow's citizens. So, being a teacher, I will get an opportunity to interact with students and to build their future, being a mentor and teacher. So, it will give me job satisfaction, nation building process, as well as good salary and good social recognition, because teacher not only gets respect from its student, from his students, but also from the parents and the rest of the society, and particularly in Hindu religion, teacher is regarded as God. This is the answer. Then, third question we are going to discuss, why you want to join OABS. So, the basic principle you must know why OABS idea is formulated. So, Odisha Adarsha Vidyalaya, sir, I want to join because OABS schools are giving the students of interior areas an opportunity to learn on par with their urban counterparts. So, by teaching in OABS, I will get an opportunity to work in an area which was education was previously inaccessible. So, it gives me immense satisfaction to go there and be a part of in their students' lives, because personally, previously they have very little education in that part of the interior area. So, this government's noble initiative, being teachers, we must go there. And apart from that, the compensation, the salary in OABS is best in teaching industry, and it will give me again the same thing, job satisfaction and to reach better heights in my career. Apart from that, I love teaching. And they may ask you, are you ready to work anywhere in Odisha? You should not think twice before answering yes. Wherever I will be sent, I will definitely be there and work there. And another question, how will you take care of student who has come from different districts to OABS? Because you know OABS is such a school where students from different parts are coming and they assemble. So thing is that I will make him comfortable, I will make him acclimatized to the environment, and the linguistic barrier has to be broken by making them fluent in English and Hindi. So I will be very, very empathetic to that student, know his mindset and give individual attention, care, love. Apart from that, motivate him to do well in his studies. Next question we can discuss, which is, might be asked, how you can manage a lazy student? So, laziness must not be mistaken, the answer is, with lack of talent. Actually, I think laziness, sometimes the lack of motivation. So, if a student is lazy, we have to identify why he became lazy, why he is not finding the curriculum or the books or the studies that much interesting. So, after identifying the root cause by asking parents or his friends, you have to create a motivation for that student. Suppose that student is interested in watching movies, we have to show him some movies which will allow him to shed his laziness and understand his real role as a student. And you see, all the successful people may not be that active, but their laziness gives them an opportunity to find out ways to do things quickly and take rest. Therefore, lazy student must not be scolded, rather they should be handled with care, and we should motivate them to concentrate on their studies from their area of interest. Then the next question, what are the qualities of a good teacher, you think? The answer is, with the changing scenarios the pandemic has struck, the quality of good teacher has undergone little transformation. Apart from being good in communication, getting his point across to the student, a good teacher must be a good facilitator. A good teacher is not someone who only knows a lot of things, only the active participant in the classroom. That doesn't mean a good teacher. A good teacher must carry his students along with him. A good teacher must involve all the students in the class and give equal attention to the good and bad students. Everybody can make a good student score good marks, but the real sign of a good teacher is he must make poor students good and make them score good marks. Apart from that, a good teacher must bear a good moral character. He must not have any vulgarity and indecency in his mannerism. A good teacher is punctual, disciplined, obedient, and abide by the rules and regulations of the schools. And the headmaster or principal, whoever is there, he must follow their guidelines. So, a good teacher is someone who inspires. So, a great teacher inspires. So, a good teacher must be an inspirational figure. So, another question may be asked from your subject, favorite subject. Suppose they will ask you, I am giving you an example, you must be ready about that subject in which you are thorough. If they ask me, what is your favorite subject? I will say English. Certainly, they will put a cross question, why English is your favorite subject? So, sir, English is such a subject which gives us an insight to the greatest minds of the world. If we look at English literature, all the great works done throughout their history of English literature is mind-blowing. Starting from Elizabethan age to the modern age, Shakespeare, Marlowe, William Wordsworth, Samuel Taylor Coleridge, John Donne, Charles Dickens, Alfred Tennyson, James Joyce, George Bernard Shaw, you name the few. All those, even if you look at our Mahatma Gandhi, who is not an English literature student, but he learns a lot because of the books he read in English literature, motivated him to take part in freedom struggle, and he was instrumental. Apart from that, why I enjoy this subject, because I love both the structural aspect, the grammar, as well as the literature. Grammar gives me an understanding how the structure of the language is, particularly it improves the communicative competence. And literature, prose, poetry, novel, gives us an idea about the society. And apart from that, in my childhood days, I used to score heavily in English. That was also one of my favorite subjects. So, in my graduation and PG, English was my favorite subject. And the final question today we are going to discuss, what are your strengths and weaknesses? This is an HR question might be put to you. So, here, just for the sake of saying something, you don't say that. What are your strengths and weaknesses? If you say that my strength is riding bike, they'll tell what are the recent bikes launched by Bajaj company, you might not be able to answer. If you say my strength is watching cricket, they might ask you what player Ruturaj Gaikwad belongs to, which state in Ranji Trophy. You may not be able to say. Therefore, you say something which you are practically good at and you have in-depth knowledge in that subject. For example, you can say, my strength is singing. If you know 2-3 songs maybe, but if you say your strength is singing, they might ask you to sing a song and you just sing that particular song in which you are good at, and you will get immediate attention and good marks. But if you say my strength is reading books, they will ask you the name of few authors which you won't be able to say. So, which thing you have habituated, inculcated thoroughly, to tell this as your strength. And as far as weakness, this is also a tricky question. You can say that I am little foodie, which actually doesn't make any difference to your selection. Sometimes I take a lot of food which might result in indigestion or acidity, but I can't resist that habit, but I am trying to overcome it. Say something which is not related to your chances of getting selected. So, you have to tell it by yourself. And in Vidyasagar classes, we are conducting interviews. If you attend our live online classes, which is going to start from 2nd of August, you will be able to encounter many questions related to your personality. So, these are the few questions. You will come up with much more questions in our coming video. I hope this small video will add to your preparation for OABS interview. Like and subscribe our channel. Click the bell icon so that you will be able to get more such videos, advanced notification in coming days. Thank you for watching. Goodbye till our next video.